Good morning, Colorado.
There it is. We have four people watching. Say hello to our viewers.
Hi, four people.
We're going to share some stuff. We're going to let you see our Undiscovered Country like promo thing. So, where'd it go?
I cannot spell.
Get on this book because it's really good. Look, you had a chance to
read. Sorry, just getting one more in there.
Turn that off. We're about ready to roll here. You got five people? Yeah? It's always nice to have some live people.
Right.
I suppose I need to see what's going on my phone.
Okay, there we go. Cool. It's in all the groups. All right. Good morning, everybody. I'm John.
I'm Dom.
We are here bright and early, midday, to bring you this week's Final Order Cutoff Roundup. So let's roll that beautiful bean foot.
What's your plan for tomorrow? Are you a leader or will you follow? Are you a fighter or will you cower? It's our time. Take back the power. What's your plan?
All right. Welcome, everybody. Happy Friday. The roads are clear. Yay.
Yes.
So that's a good thing. But we're here. We do this show for you guys every week to go over the titles that are on Final Order Cutoff this coming Monday. Final Order Cutoff, if you don't know, if you haven't watched the show or joined us before, is our last chance as a brick-and-mortar comic book store to adjust our numbers before the books actually ship out to us. So, for example, all of this stuff on Monday, October 14th, is my last chance to change numbers and guarantee that you get a book before they're in our hands on Wednesday, November 6th. So if you want to guarantee that you get a copy and not have to worry about driving all around the Denver metro area, possibly in a snowstorm, all you have to do is to comment on either this video feed, on the post that we just went live with on Facebook. You can email us, you can Facebook message the store, and let us know that you would like to sub whatever title it is, so that you can have that book added to your subscription, so that the next books, the next issues that come out for that title will show up in your hold slot. Or if you just want to pull a copy to try it out and see what it's all about and not necessarily commit to getting multiples past whichever issue, you can type pull and then the title and however many copies that you would like, whether it's a variant cover or a main cover. Did that make sense?
Yes.
I felt like that was weird the way it came out. That's what she said. But,
that's,
you know,
what
she said. So if you're watching this with us, we do this on Friday so that you have Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and most of the day on Monday to go through this stuff and let us know by 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time on Monday what you'd like to order off of this list, whether you'd like it added to your subscription so that you get the whole series, or if you just want to pull a copy to try it out and see what it's all about. But we give you guys, we're trying to give you the tools so that you can order the books that you want to order, and make sure that we have them for you when the titles come into the store, because you know nobody likes not having something that they want.
Right. It's, but we can't also order, we can't order copies of something we right. don't know to order.
That's absolutely right. We don't order everything. We can't order everything. We order based on your subscriptions. So if nobody's subscribed to it, then it's not necessarily something that I'll order. So, but that's how that's what we do. That's how this works. We're going to go over a bunch of stuff, and then at the end we'll talk about our list that's at the very, very bottom. Again, if you want to subscribe to something on here, type sub and the title. If you just want to pull a copy to read it and see what it's all about, type pull, the issue number, the cover, if there's multiple covers, all of that sort of stuff. Okay? First up, we've got Dark Horse. Dark Horse has got two titles on FOC this week that we want you to be aware of. The first of which is Crone number one, right here on the screen. It is the start of a five-issue miniseries written by Dennis Culver from Burnouts, which was a weird series published by Image about extraterrestrials and getting high, and with art by Justin Greenwood from Stumptown and The Last Siege. Stumptown is now a TV show, which is pretty
really?
Cool. Yeah, it's about a cop in Portland. So, wow. But this is not a cop in Portland. This is more sword and sorcery, a little bit of fantasy. The sword savior and champion of men, once known as Bloody Bliss, is now nothing more than a reclusive old crone. Does she have the strength to answer the call for one last adventure? Only Dennis Culver and Justin Greenwood know for sure in this story that is equal parts Unforgiven and Xena Warrior Princess.
Huh.
From Burnout's creator Dennis Culver and acclaimed artist Justin Greenwood, one more battle for Bloody Bliss. Again, this reminds me of the Mark Millar series that I can't remember. The Starlight? Is that what it was? We talked about it. I can't remember the name. It's right out here in the trade paperbacks. But it was like Buck Rogers. He had this fantastical adventure as a kid, and now is an old man, and none of his kids believe him that this adventure happened. And I don't know why I'm talking about that, because that's not what this is. But this is
yes.
very much in the same vein of that story by Mark Millar that I can't remember the name of. So, Crone, five issues from Dark Horse. The first one is in stores November 6th. Next from Dark Horse, just in time for the Frozen 2 movie coming out in theaters
right.
November 22nd, we have Dark Horse. We have Disney Frozen True Treasure number 1 of 3. It is a 3-issue miniseries from the folks at Dark Horse. During a tribute to beloved King Agnar and Queen Iduna of Arendelle. I haven't seen this movie. Is that terrible? People are gonna.
I haven't seen it either. I don't
they
have
hate
small
us.
Children, man.
Elsa and Anna stumble upon some old boxes of their parents' belongings, maybe comic books. What they find inside sparks one of their youngest childhood memories, and they begin an adventure of mystery and surprise. This 3-issue miniseries is a lead up to the highly anticipated film Frozen 2, which again, this book is going to be in stores November 6th. The movie is out November 22nd. So if you have little ones or if you dig this movie, a great 3-issue primer to check that out before you go to the movie theater.
Like what they do with Star Wars.
Yeah, exactly. Journey to Frozen 2, True Treasure number 1. That's not what the title is, but. Okay, from our friends at DC this week. So Ruby, which was it's an anime. DC is partnered with I think it's Rooster Teeth,
yes.
To adapt some of these animated anime to comic books. And so this week we have Genlock number 1 right there on the screen. It is a 7-issue miniseries. Earth is at war. The villainous Union has been steadily taking over more and more of the planet after initiating the Global Culture War.
Global
Culture War. That's kind of a tongue tie right there. In an effort to stand its ground against the Union, the Polity turns to Dr. Weller and his team of 5 individuals who are Genlock compatible, which allows them to transfer their minds to mech suits known as Holons. Spinning out of the first season of the hit Rooster Teeth animated series, Genlock follows Julian Chase and his team as they pick up the pieces of their lives after the death of Dr. Weller, leading them into a high-octane adventure in one of the Polity's last free countries, Japan. So it sounds freaking cool.
Good.
A little bit of Voltron, a little bit of, you know, maybe Umbrella Academy kind of sort of stuff. Seven-issue miniseries. The main cover is right there on your screen. I don't remember who did the main cover. There will be a variant by Jim Lee, but I don't. The artwork was not available when I typed this up last night. If you'd like to pull it to read a copy of number one and see what it's all about, type pull Genlock. If you'd like to subscribe to it to get all seven issues of the miniseries, you could type sub Genlock, and we'll make that happen for you. Okay, next up from DC this week, we've got Green Lantern Black Stars, number one of three. Three-issue miniseries. So events happened in issue 12 that came out, I think, this week. Grant Morrison is still writing this book, but he's taking a three-issue break to do this Black Stars series. Yep, exactly. So what has Hal Jordan done? Following the catastrophic events of the Green Lantern 12, no Green Lanterns can be found patrolling their space sectors, and not a single power ring lights the darkness. Across the universe, once familiar faces now wear a different uniform and enforce a new type of galactic law. The Green Lantern Corps is dead. Long live the Black Stars. Wow. Who are they? What are they? Answers will be revealed as the unstoppable Black Stars set their sights on the demons of Yasmalt, Mongol, and a tiny backwater planet called Earth. A dangerous new chapter of the Green Lantern mythology starts now. We've got the main cover on my side is by Liam Sharp. The variant cover on Dom's side is by Derek Robertson. Again, this is basically Morrison's taking a three-month break from Green Lantern to do this Dark Stars series. Black Stars, not Dark Stars. So Green Lantern will come back in November, December, January, February of next year, but this is kind of taking its place right now. So if you guys were subscribed to the Green Lantern series, we have automatically subbed you to this Green Lantern Black Stars. If you don't want that, let us know. If you weren't on Green Lantern, but you would like to pull Black Stars, let us know and we'll make that happen for you, okay? All right, next from DC in stores on November 6th is a one-shot called Infected King Shazam, which is right there up on your screen. If you read Batman Superman, you know what happened at the end of issue number one and into number two. Billy Batson is a good kid. This is going to start what DC's doing with all their infected stuff going on in November. He helps his friends, loves his family, and tries to do the right thing. But Billy is about to have a run-in with the most dangerous serial killer in existence. And the Batman Who Laughs wants Billy to be bad. Spinning out of the events of Batman Superman and You're the Villain, it's the tale of a hero whose soul has turned black and who has something to prove to the old guard. Buckle in for Shazam's journey to punch a bunch of so-called gods in the face and show the establishment exactly what the future looks like.
It's abuse.
I know, right? That's assault, brother. $4 for that one. There's only one cover. That cover right there is by Mr. David Marquez.
What's up, Mike? How are you? Our UPS guy.
Mike, our hero,
he
the UPS
live
man.
On
no, that's
right
fine.
Now.
That's cool.
Are you guys really live?
We really are live right now.
Sweet.
You need to sign something, Mike?
Let's see here.
Randy can sign it. All right. Next up from DC, this is pretty monumental. Legion of Superheroes number one is back. Right. We had the Legion Millennium two-issue miniseries that came out last couple of months. Bendis is I'm excited to read this, and I'm going to tell you why. You'll hear it at the end of the solicit here.
Okay.
Inspired by the acts and lessons learned from the greatest heroes of all time, the Legion of Superheroes have gathered together to stop a galaxy from repeating its past mistakes. The greatest lineup of heroes in comic book history returns with new, fresh, and reader-friendly stories. We got Bendis that's helming this megalith with master artist Ryan Sook for one of the most ambitious mainstream comic books ever created. Why have the Legion of Superheroes broken the cardinal rule of the United Planets and inducted John Kent, a.k.a. Superboy, into the Legion? What are they hiding, and what does it have to do with Aquaman's long-lost trident? There are four covers that will be available for Legion of Superheroes number one. The one on the very, very top here is the main cover by Mr. Ryan Sook. There is a blank cover that I don't have an image of. Thank you, Mike. We'll see you, man.
Have a great day.
You the same. Take care, bud. There's a blank cover that I don't have an image of, but generally will have trade dress and then be solid blank. And then if we go down a bit, there is the Jim Chung variant right here.
Wang Chung.
And to the far right, we have another Ryan Sook variant. So four covers total. Yeah, it's pretty cool because John Kent is pressing the computer screen that's welcoming him to the 31st century orientation. And it talks about all the different events that have occurred to cause the formation of the Legion. We will have Legion flight rings available. If you want to guarantee that you get a Legion flight ring, make sure that you subscribe to this series. They will be given out to subscription holders first, and whatever we have beyond that, you know, we'll be able to. Anybody who comes into the store will be able to pick up. But we're gonna hold those Legion flight rings specifically for people who are subscribed to this series first, and then whatever we have left after that will be available to the masses. So Legion of Superheroes number one, if you want to pull a copy just to read it, you can type pull whichever cover you would prefer. If you want to add it to your subscription, you can type sub Legion of Superheroes, and we'll get that set up for you. I'm really excited about this next one. Third or fourth Tales from the Dark Multiverse. This one is Blackest Night, which is one of my favorite DC stories of all time. And the art... So I don't know if anybody follows Kyle Hotz on Facebook or Instagram. Kyle has been doing some work with Donnie Cates on Venom and Absolute Carnage. Kyle is doing the interior art on this one-shot, and it is phenomenal. He's been posting his pages that are penciled and inked. And it's going to be unbelievable. I'm excited. I can't wait to see more from him about this. So Tales from the Dark Multiverse, Blackest Night number one, just a one shot. What could be blacker than the Blackest Night?
More Blackest Night.
It's an inside joke. From the pages of Dark Knight's Metal comes a dark multiverse retelling of the Green Lantern event that changed the DC universe forever, only this time the Black Lanterns win. So that's freaking cool. Now, 23 days after the apocalypse, witness the rise of Sinestro as the Limbo Lantern. I don't know what that means. Is that because
how low
he can...
How
low he can go? Thank you! Trapped between life and death as a white and black lantern.
No boundary lantern.
That's right. Sinestro seeks to save the universe or end his miserable life once and for all. Joined by Dove, Lobo, and Mr. Miracle, the last living beings in the universe will put everything on the line to give their world one final chance. Written by Tim Seeley with art by Kyle Hotz. And if you look at Sinestro's emblem that's on the middle of his shirt there, half of it is the white lantern and half of it is the black lantern symbol. So that is going to be awesome. It's just a one-shot, so we cannot subscribe you to it. So please, if you'd like a copy of that, type pull Tales from the Dark Multiverse Blackest Night. Okay? Next up from IDW and in stores on November 6th, we have Adam's Family, The Bodies, number one, which is a one-shot. This is a tie-in to the new Adam's Family animated movie, which comes out, I think, this week. I think it's out this weekend. No, not at all. So this one-shot comes out November 6th, but while searching the Adams Library for the creepiest grimoire, Wednesday Adams discovers a mysterious tome that promises true empowerment to the young woman who wields it. This is great. Wednesday decides to complete the dark rituals hidden within this 11-teen magazine and achieve ultimate power. I'm assuming that 11-teen is like, you know, the
16.
Yeah, exactly. That's the most evil of the tomes,
that's right.
Dom.
11-teen.
So that's a great little one-shot. It's going to be $4.99. It comes out November 6th.
I like they have a lot more Halloween
themey kind of stuff.
Yeah. There's a lot more this year, it seems like.
I agree. It's not a series that we can subscribe you to, but if you'd like a copy, comment, pull Adam's Family. We'll make that happen for you. Next up from IDW, we have another property that they are doing for Disney. I think it's on the Disney Channel. This is Big Hero 6, the series number one. Hero, Honey Lemon, Wasabi, and Go-Go are all off on a class trip for the day, leaving Fred at home to defend San Francisco. He'd better come up with a strategy just in case, and what better way to do that than by writing his very own Big Hero 6 comic book, his dad, of course, being Stan Lee from the movie. Join Hero, Wasabi, Fred, Go-Go, Honey Lemon, and Baymax for new adventures, new friends, and new adversaries as the Big Hero 6 team continues to fight to protect San Francisco. Finn is going to be nuts over that. Yeah, he loves that show. So, a new series from IDW, Big Hero 6, the series.
If you much about what Finn likes. I always hear what Oliver likes, because he tells you.
Yeah, that's true.
Gut wrenches you.
He punches you right in the stomach until you know.
You're
going to
watch it again.
Right? And again. And again. And some more. Next up from IDW, we've got another one-shot. This is part of their Mirrors... What is it? Black Mirror? Mirror's Edge? What is the mirror universe for Star Trek called?
Dark... Was it Darkness?
I don't remember.
I don't remember either.
God. But anyway, this is Star Trek Voyager Mirrors and Smoke number one. So it's just a one-shot. Stranded far from the ruins of the Terran Empire, Captain Janeway of the Rebel ship Voyager has crowned herself Pirate Queen of the Delta Quadrant.
She's a good one, too.
Yeah, right? Of course, the locals won't give in without a fight, especially not scavengers Neelix and Kes. And who is this apparent Terran who calls herself Annika Hansen? Find out in Mirror Voyager's amazing comic book debut with the cover right there by J.K. Woodward, who always knocks it out of the park. That one shot is $4.99. We can't subscribe you to it, so if you'd like a copy, please comment, pull.
So many one shots.
I know. Star Trek Voyager, Mirrors, and Smoke. Okay. Spawn hit the magical 301 number this week, making it the longest running independent comic book in the history of comics. McFarlane is now in the Guinness Book of World Records. Here we go with Spawn number 302. A new story arc starts here with Hellhunt Part 1. In the aftermath of the record-setting 300 and 301, new heroes the Reaper and Jessica Priest She-Spawn join Spawn's war against the forces of heaven and hell. The next evolution in the mythology and the power of the Hellspawn begins now, plus the return of medieval Spawn. This book includes a five-page story drawn by Todd McFarlane, which is pretty cool. I know, right? It's $2.99, so we're back down to normal cover price for a Spawn comic, but... I lied when I said that there were only going to be three covers because there are five covers. Cover A on your screen right here is by McFarlane, inked by Capullo. Cover B is the Virgin McFarlane and Capullo. Cover C is the Black and White McFarlane and Capullo. And then there is a cover D, right there. Oh, it's not up there. There's just the line. If you scroll down a little bit. It says cover D and cover E. Cover D is a McFarlane cover by himself, and then cover E is a Virgin McFarlane cover.
Yeah.
So five of them, but they're all $2.99. There's no 25, 50, 100 incentives. If you want to keep going with Spawn, if you dig what you've read so far, let us know.
So I just placed an order for like nine of them.
Really?
We're on, yeah.
Interesting.
Yes.
Okay. The big one from Image this week, you've heard us talk about it, I think, all week long. Here
this?
You go. This is some tiny, tiny book by tiny little creators that nobody has ever heard of before.
It might be a movie. That might be in production.
It's gonna be, yeah, it might already be a thing ready to go. I don't know. It's been optioned. Randy just kick-farted backwards there. So on Final Order Cutoff this week is Undiscovered Country number one. If you like Mad Max, if you like action-adventure, if you like suspense and thrillers, this has it all.
It's good. It doesn't give you enough, but no, they extended the book, too.
That's true. It's now going to ship with four extra pages that nobody knows anything about. So we don't know about it. Nobody, except for the folks at Image and Scott Snyder and Charles Soule, know about it. But it's a kick-ass book. It's a great series. It's already been optioned. We are doing a store-exclusive cover for this. You saw it in the intro for the series. Dom's going to throw it up on the screen. Bam! Right there. Our friend Jorge Corona did that cover for us. It will have trade dress, just like the two books behind it with the title and the Image logo and all that stuff. We don't have that back yet from Image. But if you would like to subscribe to this series, let us know. You can type sub Undiscovered Country. Originally, it was just going to have one cover, the cover on my side here by Giuseppe Camincoli, who's also the interior artist. They just released this week the Jock cover on Dom's side, which is, you know, also available for pre-order. But if you want either of those, or if you would like our store exclusive, let us know. You guys have been awesome coming out of the woodwork for the store exclusive, so thank you for that. We are going to make this book not our store exclusive. Let me just dial that back a second. Yeah. We will have the main cover and the variant cover available as a no risk number one here at the store, so that you can pick up a copy of it. We'll put a copy in everybody's hold slot. If you buy it and you read it and you don't like it, bring it back. We'll give you your money back. We'll give you a store credit for your next purchase. But that's how much we believe in this book. We got a chance to read it ahead of time. Same thing with Once in Future. We hope you guys are digging Once in Future. We're going to offer that same option with Undiscovered Country number
one. No risk number one. That's right. All justice.
$4 out of your pocket for some,
read something, man.
36 pages of entertainment. It's good stuff. Okay? For Marvel this week, in stores on November 6th, they decided to add another one-shot. So this is Absolute Carnage. It says Weapon Plus, but on the cover it says Weapon X. And so we have Hulk Vereen on the top left of that cover. I don't know what the actual title is, but this is just a one-shot to the Absolute Carnage series. After one of the pilot missions of the Sim Soldier program, Rick Strickland was given a highly classified mission by Nick Fury himself.
Snick Fury?
Snick Fury, pretty much. Where exactly did the ancient symbiote known as the Grendel come from? Decades later, Carnage is on a rampage that will connect him to Null, the symbiote god, and only Weapon H can stop him by picking up where Rex left off.
That's cool.
So Rex, or Weapon H, is right there. That's Snulk? Snicked Hulk?
Snulky.
The Incredible Snulk right there on the cover.
Snulk.
It's terrible.
Snicked.
This is just a one-shot. It is $4.99. The cover right there on the screen is by Scan Suraswan. It's an awesome cover. If you're subscribed to all of the Absolute Carnage stuff, we'll take care of this for you. Don't worry about it. But it's kind of coming out of left field. I think they're doing a Captain Marvel one-shot also, but that's not on FOC this week. Next up from Marvel, part of their Future Fight video game comic book series, we have, so White Fox came out this week. Luna Snow is another one that's on deck. This is Crescent and Io number one, which is just a one-shot. The all-new duo from the Marvel Future Fight mobile game star in their own one-shot. How did Dan Bai, a young girl from South Korea, first bring an ancient mystical bear spirit into the modern world? How did this unlikely duo become the evil-smashing team known as Crescent and Io? It's a little moon girl devil dinosaur, but it's a little girl with a bear, mystical bear. Excellent. This time. It also features the Marvel's Future Avengers in an all-new story. It's a one-shot. We can't add it as a subscription to you, but the gorgeous cover right there is by In-Hyuk Lee. All you have to do is comment, pull Future Fight Crescent and Io, and we'll make that happen.
Another
for
one
you.
Killing it, too.
Yeah, he is. Absolutely. Here we go. There are two new Dawn of X books that are on FOC this week. Two of them. The first of which is on your screen right there. That is New Mutants. The new generation claims the Dawn. The classic New Mutants, Sunspot, Wolfsbane, Mirage, Karma, Magic, and Cypher, get together with a few new friends, Chamber and Mondo, to seek out their missing member and share the good news. A mission that takes them into space alongside the Starjammers, which is pretty cool. So this is the 1, 2, 3. This is the fourth? Yeah, because this is the fourth Dawn of X title. The fifth one we'll get to here in a second. Cover A on my side is open to order. That's the main cover by Rod Rice. Cover B on Dom's side is the open to order Art Germ variant featuring Magic. I called it, didn't I?
Yes. You did.
Because we had no image for what the Art Germ cover was going to be. It's got to be Magic. Yeah, that's fantastic. Cover C on my side, if you want to. It's not cover C. They don't assign letters to their covers. But this is the Mark Bagley Every Mutant Ever connecting cover. And then on Dom's side, we have the Javier Garon Young Guns variant.
Like
so all four of those covers are open to order. Which means that we can order them in any quantity, so you can choose which one of those four that you would like, or you can get all four of them. If you would like to subscribe to the series, type sub New Mutants. If you just like to pull a cover, whichever cover tickles your fancy, probably Art Germ, you can type pull New Mutants Art Germ, and we'll make sure we have a copy for you. Okay? This next one I'm really excited about because my kids both love Spider-Man and Venom. This is Spider-Man and Venom Double Trouble, number 1 of 4.
first cover.
So Guru, who did that first cover, is doing the interior for this whole thing. So that's what it's going to look like inside. Awesome. You've seen him duke it out in the Marvel Universe for years, but prepare to see Spidey and Venom as you've never seen before as begrudging buddies.
Oh, God, I have to read this.
I know, right?
I have to read this.
It's fun of the freaky variety this time around as an unexpected mind swap sets Spidey and Venom in each other's bodies.
Oh, my goodness.
But who swapped them and why? From Mariko Tamaki and Guruhuru comes an all-new take on your favorite arch-frenemies in the MU, and now they've got to work together to set things right. So the main cover that's on the very top there, the very anime-style cover right there, is by Guruhuru. That's the main cover. That person's also doing the interiors. The connecting cover variant on Dom's side is by Art Adams. So that connecting cover is going to connect with like Amazing Spider-Man and Friendly Neighbor. Basically all the Spider titles are going to have that one of these pieces to the Art Adams connecting cover set. There is also an open to order cover by Paulina Genichow. I don't know how to say her last name. It's not up on the screen. There was no image for that at when I typed this up last night. And last but not least is the open to order variant right there by Logan Lubera. So you can choose any of those four, even though we don't have an image of one of them. It's a four-issue miniseries, Spider-Man and Venom Double Trouble, number one. If you'd like to pull a copy... I know, right? If you'd like to subscribe to it, type sub Spider-Man Venom Double Trouble. If you just want to pull a copy, you can type pull with whichever cover you prefer. Okay, so this is the last one. It's not the last one. This is the second Dawn of X title that we have on FOC this week. X-Force number one. The high price of a new Dawn. X-Force is basically the CIA of the mutant world, one half intelligence, one half special ops. So you have Beast, Jean Grey, and Sage on the intelligence side, Wolverine, Kid Omega, and Domino on the special ops side. In a perfect world, there would be no need for an X-Force, but we're not there yet. We got the main cover right here is by Dustin Weaver, who is doing the new character variants for Powers of 10. There's the open-to-order Mark Bagley Every Mutant Ever cover, which I just realized the image on that is the same as the image from New Mutants, but that's fine. It'll be different, I promise. And then on Dom's side is the open-to-order Russell Dodderman Young Guns variant. All three of those are open-to-order. We can get you any of them or all of them if you would prefer. Again, if you'd like to subscribe to it, please type sub X-Force and we'll get it on your subscription. If you just want to pull a copy to see what it's about, you can type pull X-Force number one with your cover preference. Last from Marvel this week, we have Yondu number one of five. It's kind of a weird... It's weird, but it's cool. It's cool because on my side, you have Yondu from the Marvel Cinematic Universe. On your side, you have classic Yondu from Guardians of the Galaxy. This issue number one drops on November 6th. Yondu, lone ravager and all-around scoundrel, is about to hit the biggest payday of his life when he stumbles upon a dangerous new weapon. But when this artifact turns out to be deadlier than he bargained for, will the reward outweigh the risk as Yondu finds himself targeted by a mysterious mercenary? Plus, when an unexpected visitor from the future turns up to stop Yondu, it begs the question, exactly how bad did he screw up? Find out in this all-new miniseries from Zach Thompson and Lonnie Nadler with an open-to-order variant cover on Dom's side by Carlos Pacheco. So five-issue miniseries. If you'd like to subscribe to it, type sub Yondu. If you'd just like to pull a copy to see what the heck it's all about, you can type pull Yondu and we'll make that happen for you. I want a whistle.
There you go.
Okay. From Boom Studios this week in stores on November 6th is BB Free, number one of 12. This is part of Boom's kind of original creator stuff that they do very, very well. BB Free broadcasts her underground radio show from her remote swamp community, and she has no idea that she's actually the chosen one. It's been over 100 years since the plague that ate greed, that's the name, the plague that ate greed wiped out half the population, and it's the only world that BB has ever known. But when she rebels against her overbearing father, she realizes that everything she believes in could be a lie. On the run from her own family, BB will learn the truth about the world she lives in and about the power she never knew she had. Written by Gabby Rivera and debuting artist Royal Dunlap, They present an adventure for fans of Blackbird and mysterious destiny heroic fiction like Naomi about finding your family when the whole world is against you.
Dana, come in.
Cover A on my side is by Royal Dunlap. Yeah. Cover B, which is on Dom's side, is by somebody with the last name of Bustos.
Oh, they're warm, John.
Are those kolaches?
No, they're Texas Roadhouse rolls.
What?
Someone brought it. Yeah, they brought two coupons for you.
I don't know what to
do. Oh,
cinnamon butter?
Oh, you're kidding me.
You guys can have the butter.
I'm okay for right now.
We're hot now.
I'm just going to be like an egg-eating snake and unhinge my jaw and eat this whole roll.
Don't be taking those whole things.
Okay. So BB... What did I say? BB Free?
BB Free.
BB Free, number one of 12. 12-issue miniseries. I love the character design. That cover A is pretty badass. It sounds a lot of fun, too. So, okay, next up from Boom, we have Magicians, number one of 5. And this is a continuation of the... It was a TV series, right? The Magicians, I think, that was on Sci-Fi, if I remember correctly. I don't remember. But anyway, Magicians is a 5-issue miniseries. There was an original graphic novel that they came out with not long ago. But this is a 5-issue miniseries. Meet the new class of Break Bills College. Series creator Lev Grossman returns to Boom for an all-new story in the world of the Magicians with Lila Sturgis and artist Pius Back. That features the first appearance of the next generation of heroes and villains. Long after Quentin Coldwater has graduated from Breakbills, Dean Fogg welcomes the first class in Breakbills history to include hedge magicians, who are known for being dangerous practitioners of unsanctioned magic. As these two student bodies clash to prove their superiority, everyone at Breakbills is forced to take a side, not realizing a new threat has targeted them all. But the reason for this change at Breakbills will rock them to their core and shock longtime fans of the Magicians. Cover A on my side is by Christina Kalita.
Uh-huh.
And cover B on Dom's side is by Alexa Sharp. Those are both open-to-order variants. If you'd like to subscribe to Magicians, the 5-issue miniseries, you can type sub Magicians. If you just want to pull a copy to see what it's all about, you can say pull Magicians with your cover preference.
It'll be popular.
Yeah. From Vault this week comes Heist, number one. Welcome to Planet Heist. It's the cutthroat capital of the entire Nearing system, home to billions of the worst men and women in the galaxy. The pan-galactic government has no idea what to do with the planet, but con man Glane Breld, I know, right? And his band of thieves know exactly what to do with Heist. They're going to steal it. It's Ocean's 11 in space.
Okay.
Brought to you by writer Paul Tobin, who did Colder and Bandette and Arjuna Sushini, The Replacer, the only minds crazy enough to steal an entire world. Cover A on my side is by Arjuna Sushini. Cover B on Dom's side is the Vault Vintage Series, which is a throwback to Love and Rockets number one by Tim Daniel. So fun sci-fi planet stealing going on right there in Heist from Vault. Okay. From Dynamite this week in stores on November 6th is Kiss Zombies number one.
Wow.
Right? Decades after a zombie invasion has made humans an endangered species, the city of New Detroit is under siege. The people in charge have banned music as the undead are attracted to sound, surprise, surprise, and have tried to rid the world of evidence that the greatest band in history have ever existed. Unwilling to live this way and take the leadership at their word, a group of teenagers set out on a dangerous trip to find Kiss. From Ethan Sachs, who's writing Old Man Hawkeye and Old Man Quill, and Rodney Buscemi from Death of Hawkman and Uncanny X-Men, comes a story of survival and rebellion in a post-apocalyptic landscape devoid of rock and roll. I don't want to live in that world, Dom.
I don't want to live in that world. I don't want to be there. Take me.
Cover A at the top on my side is by zombie master Arthur Sweetam.
Wow.
Cover B on Dom's side is also by amazing artist Stuart Sager. Cover C on my side is by Rodney Buscemi, who's doing the interior art. And cover D is the photo cover. Okay. How do you not get a photo cover with the Demon and Star Child and all those guys right there on the cover? So, I don't know that this is a mini series. It's probably going to end up being one, But if you'd like to pull a copy to see what it's all about, you can type pull with your cover preference. If you want to subscribe to it, type sub kiss zombies. We'll get that set up for you. Last but not least, we've got a Rick and Morty one-shot. Rick and Morty presents Unity, number one.
U-N-I-T-Y.
U-N-I-T-Y. It takes a special kind of madness to capture and imprison Rick Sanchez, the kind of madness only an ex can deliver. Unity wants to make a play to take over the galaxy, and she'll need the best and worst of her exes in her clutches to do it. And Rick wants his party naked t-shirt back. She stole it when they broke up.
Whoa.
Jerk. Main cover, I don't know who did the main cover that's on my side. The variant cover on Dom's side is by Cinna Grace. Just a one shot, so if you want to pull a copy, just type pull Rick and Morty Unity with whichever cover you
Cinna
prefer.
Grace is what? Zombie?
What's that? No, I can't remember what Cinna Grace. I think she's doing the Ghosted in LA series right now for Boom.
Okay.
I think.
Okay.
I can't remember. But actually, last but not least, we have your entire full list of comics that are on FOC this Monday. They're sorted by publisher at the far right, so you can go through this huge list, check out what you're interested in. You can take the item code that's this little number that's right over here, right there by me. If you copy that item code,
I'll take going to the chapel.
Too much.
Too much.
Whoa.
Mm. There we go.
All you got to do is highlight that little item code, copy that sucker, and then dump that into an internet browser, and it will pull up the very first listing that's at the top there is the Previews World page that has an image and a description for that book that's on FOC.
There we go.
So you can go through that. Let us know if there's anything that you want on there. We had a couple of people that went through and ordered some annuals that they weren't subscribed to last week. But yeah, that's what we have for you this week for Final Order Cutoff. So let us know. The cutoff is Monday, 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. As long as we have your order in before that, you will be golden, Pony Boy.
Sounds good.
I think that's it.
That's it.
All right. I'm John.
I'm Dom.
Have a safe weekend, guys. We'll see you guys next week.
Let the devil in, benevolent as I've ever been. Head is spinning, this medicine screaming.